heard that I am the man that stops you from going to the beach, so I'm gonna try to be really efficient in order to explain a little bit of facts. So this is the mouth of the Barranca River. This is the end of the Barranca River. The Barranca River comes from the occidental part of the Central Valley, so it's more or less a long trip. This is the Pacific coast. So in front of us, we have, well, in that direction, actually, because this is the Nicoya Peninsula, we have the subduction zone. So this is in between four categories of seismic risk, this is the highest. So obviously, more or less, the subduction zone is like, let's say, 60 kilometers from here. But because it's a plain, maybe we are over the subduction zone. But in this place, it has obviously a higher depth. So in this case, as you can see, we have a precast pre-stress superstructure. We have I-beams that were post-tensioned. And we have five spans, and they are simple supported. So as you can see here, the bridge in this case, in this span, was hit by an earthquake. And obviously, you can see the damage on the bearings and a displacement between this span and the other one. The thing is that because we don't have like a real protocol of attention after an earthquake or a real bridge management system running right now, we don't know what was the earthquake that damaged this bridge, for example. We don't have any idea. It could be from the 1990s, from the 80s, or so on. So obviously that is not good, because you should know what was the earthquake and you should repair the bridge after the disaster. So in this case, we don't have any idea. Probably an earthquake in that way in Nicoya at the end of the 90s, but we are not sure. And besides to that, because we are in front of the coast, we have corrosion. And that is another issue, because obviously, when you are in a zone like this, probably the resistance, the strength of the elements is like 50% of the importance of the element. And another 50% is the durability. So most of the time, the designers don't care about that. So most of the time, they don't put the correct cover of concrete and things like that. Or they put just steel without the best protection in front of the coast. So in these bridges, we have a lot of problems with durability, which is not a good thing, because obviously you have, as you already saw on the deck, we have a lot of pop-outs and corrosion and delamination and things like that. That is not good, because you can have the bridge with the best resistance, but with a low durability, it's gonna last 15, 20 years. Obviously, it doesn't have any sense, because you are spending a lot of money in one project. So that is an issue here in Costa Rica. We should put more attention on the durability. And obvious durability affects the behavior during the earthquakes, because if you have damage, obviously the performance is gonna be a bad performance, probably. And what else? Maybe some facts, some fun facts, let's say. Yeah, it's a railroad bridge, but they never built it. But that part is for a future that is never, it never gonna happen, railroad bridge. So the length of the bridge is 180 meters. Each span is more or less 35 meters. That for a precast post-tension girder is long. 35, 40 meters is like the maximum. With a simple supported girder is more or less the maximum span with this type of girders. And it was built, I don't have that here. I don't have that information. Pablo, can you help me? La de construcción, ¿cuándo se construyó el puente? Do you remember? Yeah, maybe it's the same. Maybe the 70s, probably. It is likely that with the Asheron HT64, it is very likely. What else? As you can see, the government, even if they are aware of the damage, and not only because of the earthquake and because of the, but because of the durability, they don't care. They say the bridge can stand the load, the light load. It's okay, so it's the same as the Chirripó Bridge.
Do you have information about the foundations?
Okay, the foundations, they have piles. We are not sure because we have in the drawings, we have two options. Driving piles, 35, 40 meters long. And the other option, and we are not sure what they built, they are like two 40 long piles that are 3.5 meters in diameter.
3.5 meters?
In diameter, yeah. So the drawings have two options. We are not sure what they build. So we don't have that as built drawings. That is another problem, because in most of the cases, what we have are the design drawings. We don't have the as-built drawings in the 90.9% of the cases. And obviously, that is a problem, because most of the time, there are issues on the field, changes because of the soil, and obviously, you have to know what is in there, because you can't see it. So that is another problem that we have. In the majority of the cases, we don't have the as-built drawings. And that is a big issue in terms of, you know, to study the real behavior of the bridge, and obviously soil structure interaction is really important. Most in these cases where there is a likely for liquefaction, for example, because we are in front of the coast.
Okay. Does anybody have a question?
Yeah.
Do you have as-built for the newer bridges in the country?
Huh?
Do you have the as-built drawings from the bridges that were built more recently, like the one we saw yesterday?
We're gonna do it. We're gonna do it, but yeah, we have to do it. We have to do it. We have to do it. Yeah. And changes are really usual, mainly in the case of bridges, because of the condition of the soil, and mainly because, as they told you yesterday, when at the beginning of the competition, nobody has like a real good survey of the soil. So when they enter to the site, they are gonna find interesting different things.